So welcome back and thank you for joining. If you came across this, I appreciate it. Thank you. Alright, let's go do some stuff for Reyes. Where's my horse?
Come on! There is room!
Oh, there's my horse. Whoa, horse! Alright, so which one is this one? Oh, I still have that. I still have poppycock, I think, which I'm not doing. That's my money now. Alright, so we got some stuff to do for the rebels. I'm playing both sides of the same card. Yeah. Or no, I'm just playing both sides, not the sides of the same card. Oh, it's my turn. After we're done with Reyes, though, I think we're done with Mexico, and then we start Act 3, which is pretty much the ending section of the game. Oh, Reyes, I'm here. Let's do some stuff. Oh yeah, I finally changed my outfit just a little bit. Well then.
John, excuse me.
Oye, mamita, cuando te vea la próxima vez que sea un poco más durito, ¿eh?
And I mean rougher, ¿eh?
What would your most loyal follower, Luisa, say about that?
Who?
Luisa, the girl from Campo Morada?
Her, a gentleman never tells, but she was a most wonderful... I just say she was increíble, yes. Let me tell you something. I strongly recommend her. You take her when you have the chance, my brother.
She thinks she's your wife.
My wife? These peasant girls, they believe every word a fellow says. So naive. It's really quite charming. I love peasants. Don't you love peasants? I love them. They have such purity.
Are you gonna marry her?
Ha! Marry a peasant? My dear boy, don't be absurd. I'm going to be the next president of Mexico. My wife will meet ambassadors, kings, other great men. The very thought that I would marry some peasant girl with a tight gun and the hands of a farmer. Well, I really don't think so. My mother, que Dios la cuide, would turn in her grave.
Interesting.
But come on, let's run. I've got an amazing present for you, my brother, huh? Yes? The man you seek. Together, we will bring them to justice. Let's go.
Had I known about that and remembered that would be the opening sequence of this.
Come on, mi hermano. This is the day we have both been waiting for.
There's a lot of explosives in the back of this carriage. Let's try not to get shot at, okay?
Good. I just received word of your fight with Agenda's men in El Sepulcro. Finally, De Santa is dead. So why did you not kill him yourself when my men gave you the chance?
I could see they wanted it more than I did. De Santa had given me what I needed, or I thought he had.
A lot of young boys will sleep safer in their beds now.
De Santa was only following orders. He was dumb and loyal to his awful master, but that's all he was.
Hold on, wait, how far are we going? Holy crap. Okay. I don't think there's going to be any more dialogue in between the two of them.
Where are they, Abraham?
They are at El Presidio, John. Can you believe it? The place we first met, the scene of one of my greatest victories over Allende's traitors. You could not write a better story.
It's a story I want to finish.
It is a story we both want to finish, my brother. If my rebels can take El Presidio, then we can move on Escalera. The rebels
are
happening, John.
Are you sure they're there? Escuela and Williamson?
Javier Escuela is there. That much I am sure of. I don't know about Williamson.
Escuela will do for now.
I am told they paid Allende to hide them. They have been in his protection since you arrived in Mexico. You see, you should have trusted your brother Abraham all along.
When we have him, then you can start making me feel bad. Immediately after you thank me for everything I've done for you, amigo.
Why does it look like we're going the long way? What the fuck?
I knew I had heard the name Javier Escuella before. He is from this province. They tell me he was once a notorious bounty hunter and also one of the early revolutionaries.
That sounds about right.
All before my rebellious urges took hold, of course. I think I was still traveling in Europe at the time. I was living in Madrid with the ambassador's wife.
That sounds about right as well. Escuela was always a torn man. Cynic who desperately wanted to be a romantic.
Whereas you, John, are a romantic who wants to be a cynic.
Javier would die fighting for what he believed in. He had a lot of passion, no love. Although he really admired Dutch, of course. But then we all did.
He was the leader of your little group of fortune hunters, right now.
The Dutch started falling apart, and hit Javier harder than any of them. He went crazy. It was like the one thing he'd ever believed in turned out to be a fraud.
You talk about him fondly.
It ain't exactly fun. He was close once. But he never cared for me or anybody else. Not any of his so-called brothers. He left me to die. He had a chance to save me.
Didn't he teach you any Spanish during all this time you were together?
I remember cabrón being used a lot.
Well, now you get to pay that cabrón.
I ain't here for revenge. I just need him and Williamson. So who was that girl back there?
Another loyal supporter. Three men. What? You want a name?
You can't even remember the name of the girl you're married.
Have you ever known power, John?
I'm a semi-literate farmer and hired killer. I ain't in the power game.
Then you will never have the knowledge that any woman would bear your child. And for her, you will be an honor.
I've known about enough bastards without making too many more of my own.
A man like me cannot be with just one woman. It would be an injustice to the people I have devoted my life to serve.
You have an interesting way of serving the people. Kind of like a national gigolo.
I owe it to the future of Mexico to breathe, my brother. If I can get noble blood flowing through the veins of peasants, can you imagine how great this country can be? An army of reyes, of kings.
I wish I'd never asked.
Have you enjoyed your
been a vacation. Why are you talking like this is already over?
I don't know. One way or another, this might be the end. What do you think of the Mexican people?
I ain't sure. Some of them been kind, but a lot of them tried to kill me.
Come, my brother. I know what you Americans call us. Greasers, sunburners, pepper guts. Our land of immigrants, you don't like foreigners very much.
I don't care who a man is, what he does, or where he's from. If he treats me right, I'll do the same.
It's that simple for you, isn't it? You would make a fine socialist.
What about the Chinese workers here? I hear you ain't exactly made them very welcome.
That is different. They are an inferior race.
You have all the makings of a great leader, Abraham.
Ironic.
The revolution is gaining momentum. Do you have any idea how many times I thought about the day I will march into Escalera and storm Allende's mansion?
I think I have some idea.
Soon it will be me sleeping. Silk sheets and the colonel lying with the cucarachas.
From what I've seen of Allende, you might want to wash those sheets.
You might be right, my friend.
Do you really think a revolution can work? Do you have enough men?
Revolution begins with one person, Joe.
One person ain't gonna defeat the Mexican army.
The poor are many and together we are strong. They are ready to fight.
If it does work.
It will.
If it does work, and you take down Allende, what then?
I will give the greatest speech of my life.
But after all the fighting and all the speeches are over, what will you do?
I will march on the capital and take on Sanchez himself.
All right, when Mexico's yours, you have all the power you desire, what will you do with it?
Like any great leader, my brother, I will delegate.
Huh. Okay.
Say, I'm not usually in favor of American interference, but it will be sad to see you go.
I ain't going nowhere till I have Bill Williams.
What will you do when this is over?
I want to go home, work my land, and grow old with my wife.
That is hard for me to imagine.
It's hard for me too. I've pulled this trigger too many times now. I'm getting tired.
Well, get ready to pull it a few more times, and the Presidio will be heavily guarded.
I think I got a few more left in me.
Maybe one day you can return to Mexico like Lando Ricketts, a famous outlaw come to die in the sunshine. I can always use a cynical American renegade on my staff.
I'll bear that in mind.
Alright, are we approaching it? Looks like we're coming up to it now.
Allow me some silence on the journey. I have the weight of a nation on my shoulders. El Presidio is just up ahead. Prepárate, mi hermano. This is our time.
I'm glad I didn't skip any of that. I was planning on skipping all that dialogue.
My men will launch a ruse attack on the side entrance to the fort. Meanwhile, you, my American friend, will drive this wagon at the front gate and jump off when you're close. He's been packed with 5 crates of TNT.
That sounds crazy. How long's the fuse?
Just like I say, fun times. It's plenty long enough, I think. I see you in there, amigo. Remember to jump, my friend.
Thank you. Oh my god, dude, I can't seem to move fast enough, dude. Okay, why am I using this? There we go. Okay, John, get off the fucking door, John. Okay. Okay, again. We will, like, oh my god, again. They create AI companions. Again. Who really don't help. Who really, really, really just don't help. Dude, I'm getting tired of games that do this, man. I've expressed this enough times, and I can't express it enough. We will keep the army occupied, John. You go up this way No, you fucking won't, you worthless pieces of shit. None of you will protect me. None of you will protect me. None of you will protect me. You're not very good at it. Jesus Christ, there are how many people here, and all of the fucking Mexican army seems to be going after me, dude. Fuck. Okay, look at this. Look at how many goddamn people are in this fucking courtyard, dude. And it seems like the Mexican army is only focused on me. Dude. Why do game developers do this goddamn fucking bullshit, man? That is a goddamn fucking bullshit lie. That is a bullshit lie. That is a bullshit lie. Thank you. I am not going to go up here and find him. Do you not understand how many goddamn people you don't know how to shoot and kill? Jesus, dude. Well, he's not in the tower. Fuck. Well, maybe he is, because apparently you gotta go to the top of the tower. Which I doubt he is up here. Oh my god, they literally just keep fucking spawning. Dude, again, a stupid goddamn cop-out of a game mechanic, dude. Why do you just let them keep spawning? It is not enjoyable when they just keep spawning. Oh my god, do I literally have to climb up to the very top just to do this? Are you fucking joking me? What the goddamn fuck, dude? Really? I have to climb to the very top of this just to see if he's up here. Okay, he's not up here. John, get off of the fucking ladder, man. Oh my god. Oh my fucking god, dude. I hate it. I fucking hate when they just keep spawning. That is another goddamn cop out. That is another goddamn cop out. That is another goddamn cop out, dude. Fucking cop out, goddamn motherfucking bullshit, dude. I'm getting tired of video games that do this, dude. It's not fun. It's not fun. It is not enjoyable. None of it is, dude. Thank you. Pick your head up. I bet I'm gonna get shot up here, right? A shotgun yet? All I got is a double barrel and a sawed-off.
Good to see you. I heard you was coming. You took your time, no? Come on, you're not gonna shoot your own brother, are you? We was family.
Yeah, we were. Then you and Dutch went crazy and family didn't mean so much.
So now you do the government's work.
And what do? You just work for a different government.
Come on, brother. I think we should go our separate ways, huh?
What you and Dutch did was wrong, and the way you left me was wrong. Now, I ain't the judge, but as it turns out, it's you or me.
Am I gonna have to duel him?
Might as well be you.
We thought you was dead, brother. I promise.
Hog tie truth.
Besides, I can give you beat. And Dutch, Dutch is in Colombia. I can take you straight to him.
Hmm? He's got a... His gun.
You left me to die?
And
to save your own skin. And now you expect me to care about you?
You got it all wrong, brother. I've always loved you. Even now.
God damn it. John, if you have a weapon, you don't need to be that goddamn close to him, you stupid son of a bitch. Oh my god, get through the goddamn window.
Thank you.
Oh my fucking god, dude. Know what? He stole my fucking horse. He stole my goddamn horse. And now this other fucking horse is getting... He stole my fucking horse. Like a goddamn little bitch, bro. Okay. You wanna play hardball? Let's play some fucking hardball. Come on. Oh, Javier. I'm right behind you. Oh my god, dude. Oh my god, what am I goddamn stuck on? Fuck, dude. Where's my horse? Come on, horse. Show up, horse.
Come on, amigo. I think I wouldn't want this.
Fuck, dude.
Would have killed you already. She always thought you was a creep. Let's go.
I almost fucked that up. Finally understand that.
You don't understand what happened. It wasn't like you thought it was. Whatever you say, old friend. Come on. Yeah. It was Bill. Not me.
Yeah. And he's next.
So you and Bill are back together. Two crazy men sharing a bed. Go to hell, you pathetic fool!
Put him in the cell for now, y'all.
You're gonna be locked up for a hell of a long time. Unless they choose to hang you.
Horse, stop moving.
Dutch never liked you, you know? I gave up caring about him or you a long time ago, friend. As I said...
Oh, you shit. Don't be sure about what you're doing, brother. You sold me out. Didn't that life we had mean nothing to you? Oh, you puto. Oh, one day I promise you, you're gonna regret this.
One day's about all you got left.
I hope you and your wife and children rot in hell.
You know, that life we lived is over. And when we was living it, it didn't mean nothing anyway. It was just an excuse, and we all knew.
What I knew is that you was always a puto. And you're still a puto.
Marston, come with me. The army sent reinforcements. Come.
God damn it. Yeah.
Go with your puto.
You should have gotten one other quick kicking. Whoa. What cannon, dude? This cannon. Does this thing not have a single bit of range on it? There we go.
We did it, my brother! El Presidio is ours!
Oh, it does have drop distance. Okay. Oh my god. Okay, that one's on me. How did it go through the fucking map, dude? You fucking joking me? It went through the map. Whatever, dude.
Two old friends reunited. It is a beautiful thing.
So, was that the end of Mexico?
Mr. Marston, fancy seeing you down here. I must say it's a pleasant surprise to see you.
You've done well, Mr. Marston. Now, Javier here gets to see how far the hand of justice can reach. Come on, you. Get in the damn automobile.
Can we assume one of my commitments is cleared?
Unfortunately, nothing is cleared, John, until your obligations are met. We need you to find Williamson, then head to Blackwater as quick as you can. We have reason to believe that Dutch Vanderland is in the area.
What? I thought I killed him in
your
the second one.
Sends her regards.
Alright, does that mean Mexico's done? What do you mean I still got something for Reyes? What else do I gotta do for Reyes, dude? God damn it, I gotta go all the way over here just to do this? Alright, let's go. Nope.
Whoa. Come on.
was supposed to be a treasure right here, right? Where does this look familiar? There is a treasure somewhere right here. Or is it on the other side of this wall? There it is. Are you joking me? I still can't find this one. I gotta find the second one before I can... Ah, whatever. Keep your stupid treasure. I don't need it. I can't believe I let him steal my horse the moment I jumped off of it. Nothing else going on up here.
Let's go.
Nah, you can chase him down. Maybe you should have had a pistol or something on you. Well, he should have had a pistol on him. He could have shot him before he got too far away. See, I can't help everyone, man. I got things of my own to do.
Go.
Oh, shit, I got a bolt action, man. Cool. Yes, I'm only gonna be able to do this one at day, right? Between 7 and 10.
Slow down.
Oh, well, I can start it now. So this is the last mission for Reyes, I know that. I gotta duel him right now. Did I miss a cutscene or something?
Thanks, my brother. Now the people are finally ready. Today we overthrow the Coronel.
Let's see what you got.
Hold on, before I cut you free, I think you can sit there for just a few minutes.
Untie me. We must escape now while we have the chance.
Well, one sec. There's like one other person here. Okay, I can't.
Hurry, my friend, set me free.
Senor, there are prisoners in jail who will fight on our side. Can you save them?
I will rally the peasants, sir. You go after the prisoners.
Yep, gonna hurt myself. Damn it.
Thank you.
amigo. Solo le hablas a Fran Reyes.
Oh, shoot the locks.
Let's go, my friends. Reyes is ready to attack the next match.
God, again, a fucking game. How many goddamn AI companions are with me right now? But no, none of them can help. None of them are useful. Jesus, dude. Why can you not hit him from here, John? Oh my God, John. There. Boy, there's a lot down here. Get around the fucking ball! Come around, or are you just gonna run away? Right shotgun. Okay, am I even going the right fucking way right now? If I take a left. God, do I not have enough? Still gonna shoot you.
Take Williamson. Just let me live. I will leave the country, I promise.
Not sure that's you. Finish Williamson.
You dead. We all dead.
Well, I'm going after him next. I'll outlive all of them.
All right.
Allende is dead. Mexico is mine.
Maybe was I supposed to keep him alive? Fuck. Was I supposed to keep him alive?
My people are free, and it is all thanks to you, John.
And to the people who laid down their lives. People like Luisa.
Oh, yes. She was very brave, and she will be missed. Who was she?
Your peasant girl wife-to-be?
Oh, yes, of course. She will have a day named after her. Laura's day.
Luisa.
What? Oh, yes, I know Laura as well. Magnificent girl. Like riding a pompous bull, it was, amigo. You never saw anything like it. Anyway, enough about sport. Let's get back to politics. I trust you will join us in riding on the Capitol.
I'd love to, but with Williamson dead, my jailers need me back in Blackwater.
Hey, ¿qué hacen? Levántense. Well, I must say, I'll miss you, John Marston.
I doubt you'll even remember me, Abraham, but it's been an experience. Good luck with the revolution. If you win power, remember why you wanted it.
Well, travel safely, amigo. Come on.
Well then, what I am going to do is go down to this safe house. I don't know why I was getting shot at. Okay. What I'm gonna do is go to my safe house down here in Satan, because I need to do that. It's been a little while. Actually, hold on. Let's see if this is actually available now. Watch there be nobody in here, right? Oh, now there's somebody in here.
Hi, mister.
My weapon?
Ooh, the semi-auto. Semi-auto shotgun. That's a nice one.
Esta noche voy a comer panochita dulce. A todo tu servicio. I am at your service. Buenos días, señor. I see you know your guns. Dicen.
I'll take this.
As you like.
That should do it.
Thank you for visiting my tienda. Some people like por culicia, but I drink only. Ya verás, cabrón.
You want to stop?
What the fuck was that, dude? What the fuck was that? What the fuck was that? Why was he shooting me? Oh my god, now I gotta go buy it again. Oh my god, oh my motherfucking god. Why the fuck did he literally just shoot me? Why the fuck did he literally just come out of nowhere and shoot me?
Minaj, how you doing?
What the goddamn fuck was that, bro? That's fucking annoying. What the fuck, dude?
De Santa me da besos como si fuera su hermano.
Oh, just want this.
¿Qué tal?
That's all I need for now.
I swear to God, dude, if I'm about to get shot as I walk out of this door. What the fuck was that all about, man? How far do I gotta go now? Damn, dude.
Let's go.
I'm gonna jump off my horse. I'm gonna run down this hill. I'm kind of still annoyed and shocked that I literally got shot for no reason.
McKenna, what are you doing here? Thought you were running a film company.
Oh, Marston, how the fates have spurned me. The muses cajole and lament my foolish nature. The hubris. The hubris!
It gets the best of us.
I've lost everything. Every last dime I invested in that studio is gone. The production was delayed by weather. That fool Spatchcock fell in love with the cameraman and ran off to Canada. Damn you, the gods of bad weather! And the hearts of vain men. Guess I'll have to go make dreams elsewhere.
Good luck.
It'll take more than luck.
So that's it?
Leave me now, sir.
Hello to you.
I have a career.
All right, then.
Whoa. Hello? All right, before we go there, I need to go check on my house. What is this? This is my property, so why are you out here on my property? So why is my property all boarded up? Okay, I don't remember why that's like that. Wait, where'd he go? Did it literally just disappear off the map? Why are you on my property?
Ain't this a beautiful spot?
Sure. What are you doing here?
My accounts. I'm an accountant.
Is that so?
In a way.
What's your name?
You know, it's the darndest thing. I can't remember.
Tell me your damn name and where you know me from.
Well, I know you from Mexico. I know you from back out west. I know you from all over.
Tell me your name or I won't be responsible for my actions.
Oh, but you will. You will be responsible. This is a fine spot. See you around, cowboy.
Damn you!
Yes, many have.
And now he's just fades out of nowhere, right? He's the devil.
Go. Come on.
Oh man, this is a long mission. Crap. We are now here in Blackwater.
Day's work for an honest day's pay.
Then looks can be deceiving, pal.
Perfect. As honesty is, in my business, the worst policy. I work for a well-respected governor, Nate Johns.
That makes sense.
Now, there is a certain individual spreading nasty rumors about Mr. Johns. I'd like you to put a stop to this vile gossip and malingering.
Suppose I can handle that for the right price.
Now, this individual has had the misfortune to be photographed enjoying some rather inappropriate company. Been seen with a local whore. Take these photographs to him. After you take care of business, return to me and I'll pay up the reward for your services. You're doing great things for your state, dear friend. You should be proud.
Morningstar? What the fuck is that Morningstar shit in the back? I just saw this. Hold on. Morningstar Ferry. The Morningstar represents refers to Lucifer the Fallen. The fuck? I never knew that. I never noticed that until just now. Okay. Where am I going? How far do I gotta go? Where do I have to go? Is it just here? All right, hold on. Also, I need to go over and buy myself this property so that way I can spawn up here, not anywhere else. Like over in McFarland Ranch. Well, go get it. I'm not doing your job for you.
Brand me like a steer in.
No thanks. Those days are over.
These cards are ready for your hand.
Carruthers keeps 101 packs in that hell wall.
Can't I buy this place? I'll save, just to be on the safe side. Supposed to give this to?
Easy there, lady.
Where am I supposed to take these? Am I really just supposed to take it to him? Or whoever this person is? Between 7 a.m. and 6 p.m. All right, fine. You got 15 minutes. Isn't there a gun shop up here? Not that I really need it. Okay, we'll go up the road a ways and go do this real quick. Is this where I'm supposed to go? What the fuck just happened? Did I get rid of it? Oh. Well. Did he tell me where I had to go and I just didn't hear him? Or am I supposed to go to the lobbyist? It's better not start a different mission when I do this.
Hey there, fella. What do you think of our governor, Nate Johns?
Nate Johns? Why, that no good lying, backstabbing bastard, I'd like to see him horsewhipped. Why you ask, friend?
Need to make sure I had the right man. Would you care to take a quick look at a couple photographs of you coming out of a fine place of not much repute? What?
As I was saying, before I was so rudely interrupted, Nate Johns is a fine, fine man and an even better governor. And I consider it an honor to call him my friend.
Wise man.
Yeah, okay. No? Really? Really? Then why is this building here? Whatever. Fine, we'll go over here.
I'm here to see Mr. Ross.
107, 109.
Edgar Ross.
113. Upstairs on the right. 114. 115. 116.
Mr. Marston, so glad to see you. How was your journey?
Where's my wife and son?
Being well looked after. Well looked after.
I want to see him.
Mr. Ross wants to speak with you. We've had some important developments.
You want me to take out a gun and blow a fucking hole in your head right here? Right now? You want that?
Mr. Marston.
You want that?
Mr. Marston, I ask you to calm down.
Why? Why? I did what you asked. I got you Williamson and Escuela. It's over. Stop playing games with me.
No one's playing games with you, Mr. Marston. But if we were to play some games, it'd be some interesting ones we could play.
Like Red Dead Redemption?
Like hanging you for murder. Or confiscating all your property. Like that little farm of yours. Or having you put in an electric chair. Those are the sort of games we could play. But we choose to play a
you
different
game. You bowler head fucker.
So calm down. And play along with us.
Where's my wife?
You know, I forget. But I hear it's very nice this time of year. Mr. Marston, please. I've never insulted your meager intelligence. Do not insult mine. We've done this little deal for your freedom in exchange for all your men from your old gang. You gave us Williamson and Escuela. We still don't have Vanderlyn, but now we know where he is.
Then go and shoot him.
No, sir. I want you to shoot him for me.
Isn't that blackmail right there? But
the last thing I want to do is make martyrs out of all these people. He could be killed by some petty squabble by another lowlife.
We believe Vanderlyn is holed up with a group of renegades near the wreck of the Serendipity Riverboat.
Yes. Another group of renegades. Obviously, the first group, your group, has, shall we say, been disbanded. Anyway, Mr. Ford and Mr. Marston, shall we go? Oh, Mr. Marston, your wife and son are doing well.
Aren't they here in this building?
I'll try to ensure they stay that way.
Good to you, sir.
Fuck you.
Oh, Mr. Marston, one more thing. This is for you.
You're too kind.
See, I have nothing but your best interest at heart.
Let's hope it doesn't go off by mistake.
Is this a model 1911?
343. I have a patent for that, sir. This is an outrage. Oh, Mr. Marston. You're alive.
Hello, Wes Dickens. I thought you were headed to Peking.
So did I. A long story. But now it seems I'm being put under arrest and charged with narcotic possession or some other such nonsense.
Ross, have him release this man.
Why?
Because he's a harmless old fraud, the kind of man that built this country. And because he helped me get Williamson.
Did you hear that, officer? The man's a hero. Let him go. Come on, Marston. Moral degeneracy waits for no man. Let's hurry along.
344, 345, 346, 348. An automobile. Is this a Model A? Fuck, I would love to have a Model T.
Head for the wreck of the Serendipity, Mr. Fordham. Isn't this something? Lawmakers and lawbreakers working together for the good of civilization.
Lawmakers.
Like you always say, sir, the higher the stakes, the smarter you have to play the game.
I can't imagine I ever said anything quite so trite. In any case, I'm not sure Mr. Marston would agree with us.
Unfortunately, Mr. Marston isn't broad-minded enough to appreciate the unique opportunity we're offering him.
Son of a...
Best watch your damn mouth!
And it's strange you should say that, Mr. Marston, because according to my files, you are the whore's son. Now, what else can I recall from the files?
Let's see.
You killed hundreds of innocent people. You've robbed at least 40 banks that we're aware of.
They told us there was a prize when you got to 50.
I'm glad this is all such a joke to you.
I want my family.
And I'm sure all the men you murdered wanted their families too. Come on, you're stupid. But you're not that stupid. We both know how this has to be. And it could be all over today. As soon as we find Dutch Vanderlyn, you can go back home and play being a farmer again or whatever else you've been pretending to do for the last few years.
First it was Bill, now it's Dutch. After Dutch, it'll be somebody else. Where does it end?
It ends when we say it ends. You're in no position to make demands.
Like you will. You don't just walk away from that. Buy a few chickens and make it all disappear. You should be dead or rotting in a jail cell by now. We are giving you a chance at new life. A chance at redemption. You can't erase your past, Mr. Marston. But we can. Such an elegant way to travel. What do you think of this automobile, Mr. Marston?
Slow,
but so convenient and reliable. Are you comfortable?
No.
You see this, Mr. Ford? The brooding cowboy. There aren't many of these left, you know. A bit of a cliche, admittedly. But still a dying breed, like the buffalo.
just as dumb, but not quite as noble.
They move most cows by rail these days, I hear.
Not where I'm from, they don't.
But you aren't from anywhere.
A new dawn is breaking, Mr. Marston. This is the age of the machine.
And soon, we'll all be living on the moon.
Maybe. This is the future. Anything is possible. Finally, this godforsaken land is entering the 20th century. Prosperity has arrived.
In the form of assholes like you.
It's not far now. The old Serendipity Wreck has been used as an occasional criminal hideout for years. We were informed that Vanderlyn and his gang are making camp there. We'll stop on the cliff above, and you and Agent Fordham will go on foot. I'll stay with the vehicle and keep watch.
And you'll do as I say, Marston. Don't try anything stupid.
Oh, I think he knows what's at stake. Don't you, Mr. Marston?
Let's find Dutch and finish this.
Come on then, Marston. You're with me.
Seems to be a lot more over here than it.
Keep quiet and stay close.
Yes, sir.
Vanderlyn is the priority. We go in, take him down, get the hell out of here. Quick and clean.
You leave Dutch to me. We don't want you getting that suit dirty.
If you step out of line, even once, well, I hope you're aware of the consequences. Seems real quiet, don't you think?
You tell me.
Maybe Dutch caught wind of things. That informant better not have been lying to us. Keep your eyes open.
They are open. I don't see nothing.
Man, it doesn't feel right. This place is usually teeming with lowlifes.
Wait, wasn't the Serendipity the boat that we all shot up in the second game?
Someone up there. You go investigate. I'll keep watch here.
Okay.
Hurry, there's somebody up there.
He's not going anywhere, bro. First off, I'm lost. Second off, where's the fucking stairs? It's a trap.
Over here! I found him!
Good God, that's our informant! Nostis, what the hell's going on here? It's a trap! Shit, Marston! You'll have to carry this man! I don't think you can walk!
Damn it! I gotta carry and shoot at the same time?
We need to clear that.
That's not all of them. Look how many red dots there are, you dumbass.
Oh my good God! Come here!
He just looks so helpless. He's like a dead fish right now. You could bring the car down here.
Who's this? What in God's name is going on?
Marston, lift this fellow into the back seat.
Again, I'm doing all the heavy lifting here. This guy's probably 250 pounds.
Let's go. There might be more of them.
Christ alive! What the hell happened down there?
It was a trap. They were waiting for us.
And who is this savage? A prisoner?
This is the informant, sir.
With me, Fordham.
We found him tied up on the boat, and then they jumped us.
Nice of you to help us out. Hell of a plan sending in two men to take on an entire gang of outlaws, especially when one of them's an office clerk, or social secretary, or some such.
Just shut your mouth!
Are we about to get ambushed again? I forget. Oh my god! Quit running serpentine patterns!
Do you wanna die? I can't see any more. Fordham, are we ready?
Yes, sir, I think so.
Maybe I should have pulled out this sniper rifle. Oh well, it's already done.
Damn, that was close.
We're lucky to be alive. I'm beginning to see why Mr. Marston here has made it to such a ripe old age.
You make me blush with all these kind words. So much for this automobile of yours. If this is the future, God help us all.
It's not the automobile. Bad workmanship and blame is tools. Perhaps if Mr. Fordham maneuvered it with a little more finesse.
I was trying to escape an ambush, sir.
Even if it was running fine, they'd still have caught us. I can walk faster than this piece of crap. Give me a horse anyway. So what now? Do I get to see my family?
Where is Dutch Vanderlyn?
I don't know.
In that case, old boy, you don't get to see your family. It's a fairly simple agreement, Mr. Marston. Even for a man as devoid of intellect as yourself, if you'd like me to explain it to you again, I'd be more than willing.
No, you said enough.
We'll find Vanderlyn soon enough. For now, however, I suggest we call it a day.
So how does it feel, taking a man's wife and child from him? Does it make you feel good?
How does it feel to kill hundreds of men in cold blood?
You're a coward.
You're a murderer. Actions have consequences, Mr. Marston.
side? There ain't no bright side.
Your family is enjoying a much-needed vacation, and in far more luxurious surroundings than those to which they are accustomed.
They're in that building.
You will be able to start a new life that will solve all your sins. I can think of far more upsetting alternatives. We should take the ending to Professor McBloom. See what he can get out of it.
Good idea, sir.
I just can't communicate with them. Here we are. Thank God for that.
So, this is the office of an anthropologist named McDougal. He was thrown out of Yale for a degeneracy.
We should tell you something.
Indeed, but he's been helping us deal with the natives in this area.
They see him and they presume we're all idiot academics.
Huh? Give me a hand here, Marston.
Ah, Mr. Ross, Mr. Fordham? Good day, good day. What on earth's going on here?
Kid got shot in the leg. Beat up pretty good.
We'll send a doctor. Now, McDougal.
Mm-hmm.
We need information from this fellow about Dutch Vanderland. Can you see what you can find out for us?
Do my best, sir.
Make sure you do.
Professor McDougal has been a good friend of the U.S. government, Mr. Marston, just like you. Why don't you see if you can help him in his study of the native problem in this county? That's a good thing.
You're the only one? Alright, we'll get one more out of the way. Let's see what's going on. Agent Ross. Is the G stand for government? Probably. They're in this building. They've been in this building the whole time. Ooh, I'm sniping.
Pleasant surprise, Mr. Marston. An informer just told us some interesting news. Our mutual friend, Mr. Vanderlyn, is about to pay call on his bank manager. What do you say to have a little financial discussion with the fellow? This way.
Let's get up on the roof. We'll have a clear shot at them from there. Door is the only way in and out of the building. So cover it tight. You see those horses to the left by the building across the street? Dutch's boys hitched them there. They'll have to run that way to make their escape. Don't start shooting until they're out in the open. If we spook them, they might retreat back in the hole up inside. Don't shoot till I give you the signal. Keep your sights trained on that bank door.
You ain't no meaner than I've seen before.
Nobody shoots until I say. Someone's coming out. He's unarmed. Hold your fire. They shot him dead. They're coming out. Gun them down. Take out those snipers in the window.
Thank you.
careful. There may be some innocent people there.
Can I change from that to sniper rifle, please?
Hello, Dutch.
How's Abigail?
Well, I hope. Ain't seen her for a while.
Cause you been chasing me?
Let the woman go, Dutch.
Of course. Of course. How's your little boy?
He ain't so little now.
No, he must be what? 15? 16? Doesn't time fly?
Don't adjust. It's over, man.
Of course. Of course.
Why are these two in the room with me?
You're the master now.
There should have been one guy outside the door.
You left me to die. We all make mistakes, John. I never claimed to be a saint. But equally, I never took you for an errand boy.
Just trying to help my family, Dutch. By making compromises, we all have to. Now let her go. It's over.
You want the girl, John? You always were the romantic sort. You know, gentlemen, this man here, oh, he married a whore. Used to ride with us. We all had her. But he married her. And you know that makes him a better man than us. He's a better man. Have the girl, John.
Easy, Dutch.
She's a parting gift from me.
No! God damn!
Let's get after him! I don't feel! What the hell happened in there? This is your fault, Marston!
You got a gun too, Sheriff.
You waited too long!
Next time, I'll just shoot the girl.
Get on your horses. I just saw Dutch make a run for
it. Come on.
Whoa.
Dutch, if it was an option.
Hallelujah! I think we're finally
Can we ride faster, please? If you want to catch him? Oh my god, I'm missing every goddamn shot, bro. Standing out in the open doesn't seem to help. Oh my god! Stupid AI companions aren't doing anything to help. All of them are standing around waiting for me to do it. I'm getting tired. I'm so goddamn tired of that shit, dude. Off the horse, John. Okay, they again seem to know right where I am, but I can't seem to figure out where they are.
Where's Dutch, Marston?
He got away.
Scared to shoot him? Too much to handle?
When the opportunity presents itself, I'll put a bullet in him, don't you worry. Won't like myself for doing it, but I'll do it.
Ah, good man, good man. You know, at the end of this, you'll probably get a medal. I know I shall.
Upstanding citizen, huh?
Let's go.
Is that a bear? Is that a boar? Whoa. I hear something big. Is that the bear? Where's that bear? Okay, so who's next? MC. Oh, the doc. Oh my fucking god, bro. Where did you come from? Now you're dead. Fuck you. Did I miss him? How did that happen? How? $5.
Welcome. mister.
Really? This is a God-fearing store to God-fearing people. You want something else? If we don't have...
Sorry, forgot that would happen.
You don't need it.
Well, this is all you got?
Okie dokie.
That should do it.
Thank you everybody for joining. If you stuck around to the end, I appreciate it. Thank you. So please have a good day. Please have a good night. And always, I am still hoping you're having a good life. And hopefully I will see you when we finally catch up with Dutch and figure out what he's been doing. Maybe put a bullet in him. I don't know. But thank you everybody for joining, and hopefully I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye, everybody.